Hi, nice to see you again. Today, we shall look at Lesson 74, Out of the Limelight, 舞台之外。What do you expect from such a title? 大家觉得这样一个标题会告诉我们一个什么样的故事呢？ My guess is, the story is about some actors and actresses when they are not acting. Well, what is your guess?
大家的猜想是什么呢？
We shall wait and see who has hit upon the right answer. Before that, as a rule, let's have a brief look at the keywords and expressions. Keywords and expressions. Limelight. Precaution. Disguise. Fan.Shady, sheriff, notice, sneer. Now we're ready for the story. Please bear the following questions in mind while enjoying the cartoon. The questions will help you understand the story better. Where did the bus stop?And who got off?
大巴停在何处？谁走下车来？
How were the actors and actresses dressed? And why had they dressed like this?
那些男演员和女演员装扮成什么样子？为什么要穿成这个样子？
What did they plan to do by that dry river bed?
在那个干涸的河床旁，他们打算干什么？
Did they have their picnic at that shady spot in the end? Why or why not?
最终他们在那个树荫处享受了野餐了吗？为什么？
An ancient bus stopped by a dry riverbed, and a party of famous actors and actresses got off. Dressed in dark glasses and old clothes, they had taken special precautions so that no one should recognize them.But as they soon discovered, disguises can sometimes be too perfect. This is a wonderful place for a picnic, said Gloria Gleam.
It couldn't be better, Gloria, Brinksley Mears agreed. No newspaper men, no film fans. Why don't we come more often?
Meanwhile, two other actors...Rockwall Slinger and Merlin Greaves had carried two large food baskets to a shady spot under some trees. When they had all made themselves comfortable, a stranger appeared. He looked very angry.
Now you get out of here, all of you, he shouted. I'm sheriff here. Do you see that notice?It says, no camping, in case you can't read.
Look, Sheriff, said Rockwall. Don't be too hard on us. I'm Rockwall Slinger, and this is Merlin Greaves.
Oh, is it? Said the Sheriff with a sneer. Well, I'm Brinksley Mears, and my other name is Gloria Gleam.Now you get out of here, fast!
So, that's the story. Did you enjoy it?
大家喜欢这个故事吗？
And have you made the right guess?
在听之前，你的猜想对了吗？
Now, think of the four questions I put to you before the cartoon. Have you now got answers for them?
我们一起来看看前面四个问题的答案。我们的第一个问题是
Where did the bus stop? And who got off?
答案应该是
The bus stopped by a dry river bed And a party of famous actors and actresses got off
第二个问题
How were the actors and actresses dressed? And why had they dressed like this?
答案应该是
They were dressed in dark glasses and old clothes because they didn't want to be recognized. 第三个问题 What do they plan to do by that dry riverbed? 答案应该是 They planned to have a picnic. 最后一个问题 Did they have their picnic at that shady spot in the end? Why or why not?答案应该是否定的。No, they didn't. Because a sheriff appeared and ordered them to move out immediately. Now you understand why the disguise of those actors and actresses got too perfect. 原因是 the sheriff simply couldn't recognize them. Well, if he could, do you think he would still be so rude to them?
假设警官能够认出这是一群男影星、女影星，大家认为他还会这么粗鲁无礼吗？好的，闲言少叙，下面让我们一起来看看课文中的一些语言点。首先，请看这样两个词 ：actor、actress。我们注意一下它们的构成 ：actor 男演员，由动词 act。加上 OR 构成 Actress 女演员由动词 act 加上后缀 ESS 构成那么 OR 或者 ER 通常是表示男性的后缀而 ESS 通常是表示女性的后缀我们再多看几个例子 Waiter 男侍者 Waitress 女侍者Host, 男主人 Hostess, 女主人 Steward, 空中服务员 Stewardess, 空中小姐 Prince, 王子 Princess, 公主类似的词还有很多我们就不再一一列举再请看课文中这句话Dressed in dark glasses and old clothes, they had taken special precautions so that no one should recognize them. 在这句话中，请大家把注意力放在 dressed in 上面。这个词组的意思是什么呢？它的意思是以某种特殊的方式着装。请多看几个例句。He was dressed.In a black suit, 他穿了一件黑色的套装。那么 dressed 还可以用在一个非常有意思的词组里面，这个词组是 dressed to kill， 类似我们汉语所说的“衣不惊人，誓不休”这种意思。那么 she arrived at a party dressed to kill as usual， 意思是说她到了晚会现场。还是和平常一样穿得光彩照人。好，还回到 dressed in dark glasses and old clothes 这句话。这一次呢，请大家把注意力放在 so that 上。So that 是英语中一个非常有用的表达法，它的意思是以便于怎么怎么样。请大家多看几个例句。Any holes and openings should be fenced so that people can't fall down them. 所有的洞和开口都应该用栅栏围上，这样人们才不会掉下去。再比如 ,He has to earn lots of money so that he can buy his children nice food and clothes. 他得挣好多好多钱，这样才能够给孩子们买好吃的。和好穿的。好，我们往下接着看。Do you see that notice? It says no camping. In case you can't read, 除非你们根本就不识字儿。请大家注意 in case 这个表达法。在英语中 ，in case 这个表达法有不少意思。 第一个意思可以这样的表述 It is used to introduce something that may possibly happen, which is the reason why something else is done. 关于这种用法，我给大家准备了两个例句，请看。I ran away down the hill in case she tried to follow. 我一路跑下山坡，就怕她追了上来。再请看 I've got the key in case we want to go inside. 我随身带着钥匙呢，这样我们要进去也可以了。In case 还有另外一个意思，这个意思可以这样表述。It is also used when you are giving a piece of information in order to introduce the reason why you are giving the reason. 关于这种用法呢，我也给大家准备了两个例句，请看。
Little Melanie, in case you've forgotten, hasn't forgotten you.
你可能已经忘了小 Melanie, 但是她可没有忘记你。
In case you didn't know, there are three basic wines, red, white, and rose.
如果你不知道的话，让我告诉你有三种酒，红酒、白酒和玫瑰酒。好，请看课文中最后一个语言点。
Look, Sheriff, said Rockwell, don't be too hard on us.
在这句话中，我想提醒大家注意这样一个词组 be hard on somebody. 这个词组的意思是 if you are hard on somebody, you treat them severely or unkindly. 它的意思是很严厉地对待某人。我们请多看两个例句。
Don't be too hard on your kids.
对自己的孩子不要太严酷了。
Goodness, that seems a bit hard on the wife.
天哪，这个对妻子来说可是太严厉了。好，课文中的语言点呢，我们就讲到这儿。现在让我们一起来看看课文中一些句子的时态。请看这个例句
Dressed in dark glasses and old clothes, they had taken special precautions.
这个句子的时态大家判断出来了吗？对，这是一个过去完成时的句子。请看从课文中摘取的第二个例句
Meanwhile,Two other actors had carried two large food baskets to a shady spot under some trees.
这个句子的时态想必大家也已经判断出来了，依然是过去完成时 had carried. 这是从课文中摘取的第三个例句。
When they had all made themselves comfortable, a stranger appeared.
在这个句子中，虽然主句是用的一般过去时，但是时间状语从句中依然使用了过去完成时 had made。因此，就让我们抓住这个机会，总结一下过去完成时的用法。过去完成时的第一种用法是用来表示 a past in the past， 也就是我们常说的过去的过去。请看几个例句。
By the time the kids got home, she had already finished the work.
当孩子们回到家里的时候，她已经做完了工作。这儿
，she had already finished the work 用的是过去完成时，
因为在孩子们回家之前，她已然干完了工作，表达的是过去的过去。再看例句二。
They had lived in New York for over 10 years when we moved in.
当我们搬过来的时候，他们已经在纽约住了十多年了。这个地方 had lived in New York 也是表达的过去的过去， 所以使用过去完成时。再比如 I had known him for quite a long time before you offered to introduce him. 在你提出要把他介绍给我之前，我认识他已经很长时间了。 Had known him for quite a long time 发生在 you offered to introduce him to me 之前，这也是过去的过去，所以依然使用过去完成时。除此之外呢，过去完成时还有另外一种用法，这种用法就与虚拟语态相关，通常是对过去某种状态的一种虚拟。请看相关的例句。
If you had worked harder, you wouldn't have lost the job.
你如果学习更用功一点儿，你就不会丢掉这份工作了。那么它隐含的意思是你没有学习的工作的更努力，所以这是一个虚拟。
If you had worked harder,
我们用过去完成时来表达。
I felt as if I had known her all my life.
我觉得我认识她已经有一辈子了。那么隐含的意思是我认识她并没有一辈子。我们用
as if I had known her all my life 这样一个过去完成时来表示虚拟。 I'd rather you had failed in the exam.
我倒宁可你在考试中失败呢。那么隐含的意思是你在考试中并没有失败，所以我们用 had failed in the exam 来传达。最后
I had meant to warn youBut you just didn't give me a chance to talk.
我本来是想警告你的，可是你根本没有给我说话的机会。隐含的意思是，我没有说话的机会，所以我没有警告你。我们还是用过去完成时 had meant to warn 来表达。好，关于过去完成时的用法，我们就总结到这儿，一共是两种用法。或者表示过去的过去，或者是对过去事情的一种虚拟语气。
Now, do you still remember we covered 6 language points in lesson 74?
在第74课，我们总共讲述了五六个语言点。
About the contents of the text. We came across a group of famous actors and actresses.
这一课讲的是一群很有名的电影明星。
Do you know that in UK, people, especially teenagers, can also become crazy fans of pop stars?
在英国也和中国一样，有很多很多人，尤其是青少年，成为狂热的追星族。
Do you know that in UK, pop stars also enjoy some privileges?Because they have been made a sort of idol.
在英国也和中国一样，很多的影星呢享有很多的特权，因为他们被视为偶像。
最后 Do you know that in UK, pop stars also pay high prices for the privileges they enjoy? For example, they lose their private lives.
在英国和中国一样，那些偶像影星也为他们的所得付出了昂贵的代价，比如他们的私生活经常被媒体曝光。
好的， That's all for lesson 74. Thank you. See you next time.